My latest art effect is the Alchemagickal Lucid Dream Box. I refer to alchemy in the sense of systematic exploration of tools and materials in pursuit of transformation, not transmutation of base metals into gold, but transformation of consciousness. I've always thought of my own work as an alchemic enterprise, metamorphing my curiosity, thoughts, and discoveries into words that educate, influence, amuse, and/or persuade others, and pay my bills in the process. The products have been painted, sculpted, formed from wood, animated by electronics. And now, I'm making the artistic creations of this process, previously a personal enterprise, available to others. I consider the first 66 years of my life to be an apprenticeship in the art and science of creating art objects that are also designed to be transformative instruments. I use the term magical in the sense of the application of intention, attention, and ritual to effect a change in the mind of the magician. The ritual of constructing this artifact invokes and requires a heightened, continuous, and sharpened consciousness on my part that the object I am bringing into being is intended as a laboratory instrument for the exploration of mind. The use of the artifact and its subcomponents in the context of a personal ritual by the owner of the artifact is intended for a specific end: the awakening of the artifact owner to the fact that she or he is dreaming. Lucid dreaming is a scientifically verified phenomenon that describes the learnable ability to recognize when you are dreaming and then to direct the action in the dream according to your own intentions. You can entertain yourself. You can create. The writer Robert Louis Stevenson, chemist Kekulé, mathematician Poincaré, and many others have recorded their use of lucid dreams as problem-solving laboratories. You can get sensual, or you can go spiritual. Learning to awaken from dreams is a skill that can be exapted to learn how to awaken from consensus trance. As the old Sufi saying goes, are you sure you are awake and not asleep in life's waiting room? Nearly 30 years ago, I co-authored with Stephen LaBerge a book on lucid dreaming. LaBerge, who at the time was a researcher at Stanford's Dream and Sleep Laboratory, where REM sleep was discovered, had perfected methods by which people could recognize and take control of the dream state, steering perfectly lifelike mental worlds into realms of sensuality, spirituality, creativity of the dreamer's choosing. I helped Dr. LaBerge write the book, and in the process, I learned to direct my dreams. I will explain the use of the artifact as a ritual instrument in the context of describing the box. The box itself is constructed of Peruvian walnut and maple. The false bottom of the box is painted plywood. Under the false bottom is a battery-powered MP3 player, amplifier, and speaker connected to a switch so that the piano music of Erik Satie plays when the box is opened. The contents of the box include ingredients and instruments for the induction of lucid dreams. The ingredients that I did not make or grow myself include essential oils of rose, mugwort, lavender, and camomile, a package of lucid dream inducing tea, and a vial of lucid dream elixir, both from Evolver, a trusted source. I grew and dried roses, lavender,
mugwort, and camomile,
and sewed them into a pillow made from fabric printed with the image of the Hindu Buddhist demi-god Garuda that I painted on canvas 40 years ago. Included are a wooden pen that I turned by hand and a small book that I bound as a copy of Exploring the World of Lucid Dreaming, a practical guide that I co-authored with Stephen LaBerge in 1988, and Excursions to the Far Side of the Mind, a collection of my essays, also published in 1988, which includes a chapter on dream work. The box and its instruments support a ritual that will lead you into the realm of lucid dreaming. The ritual instructions are written in the book, which is divided into several parts. In addition to the instructions I have written for the ritual are pages for you to write your intention to awaken to your dreams using the pen that I hand-turned from wooden blanks that I prepared myself.
We gotta get your visor up. It's
I'm smiling.
As described in Exploring the World of Lucid Dreaming, before you perform your nightly ritual, you should establish a habit of questioning reality. Write, "Am I dreaming?" on a small card and carry it with you at all times. Take the card out once or twice an hour, read your message, and test reality. Dreams can look as real as waking life, so you need to do something that will determine whether you are dreaming or not. I recommend taking a small hop. If you return to the ground, you are probably awake. If you float, you are undoubtedly dreaming. The first step in the ritual you are to practice at bedtime is to open the box. The music by pataphysician Erik Satie has a quality that is both lucid and dreamlike. Within the box is a dream pillow. Make the tea, use the elixir if you wish. Before you get into bed and turn out the lights, write in the book the date and your intention, "Tonight I will awaken to my dreams," or any other similar phrase. Use the other pages to record your adventures. It's best to record actions and images and feelings from your dreams as soon as you awaken. Instructions on what to do when you attain the lucid dream state are detailed in Exploring the World of Lucid Dreaming.